Come Holy Spirit, renew the face of the earth. Come Holy Spirit, cast your fire, give us new birth. Come with your power, come with your grace. Come Holy Spirit,
especially chosen to be with you, O God, all eternity.
Amen.
All eternity, O God, is a promise you have given us. And we are special, Lord. Today, as we come into your presence to acknowledge we are chosen, we are not alone, you are our God.
But he brought me in, oh, his love for me. Oh, his love for me. Oh, the sun sets free. Oh, it's free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. In my there's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. Free at last, he has ransomed me. His grace runs deep. While I was a slave to sin, Jesus died for me. Yes, he died for me.
who the sun sets free, oh, is free indeed. I'm a child of God, yes I am. In my Father's house there's a place for me. I'm a child of God, yes I am. In my Father's house there's a place for me. I'm a child of God, yes I am. Not forsaken, I am who you say I am. You are for me, not against me. I am who you say I am. I am who you say I am. I am who you say I am. There's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. In my Father's house there's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am.
You are holy, you are with me. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, renew the face of the earth. Fill us with your love, peace, and joy. You are the promise of the Father. Abba, Father, we remain in your presence, opening our hearts for your Spirit to fill us, that we may live in peace and joy and love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear sisters and brothers, what am I living for? Am I happy with the way I am living? Have I asked that basic question ever? You know, my dear friends, in our busy life, we go about our day-to-day affairs, shouting at others, being shouted at by others, being sad, being irritated, at the end of the day, tired, often guilty, regretting for what we are doing, and at times asking the question, am I wasting my life? You know, my dear friends, there is a beautiful word the Lord said to the apostles during the Last Supper. John chapter 15, verse 16. It is not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will remain. It is not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit. Fruit that will remain. Jesus is speaking about a choice, a call, an appointment. For what? To bear fruit. And this is a word to everyone who follows him. They're not by chance, by accident, living on the face of this earth. We are called, we are chosen, we are appointed for a purpose. And what is that purpose? that purpose is to bear fruit. What is that fruit? The fruit of the Holy Spirit. Every one of the disciples of Jesus, the moment we choose to follow Jesus, we must know that. That choice is not mine or yours. The choice is of the Lord. And that's why Jesus said, it's not you who chose me. I chose you when? Before the foundations of the world. We are chosen, we are called, we are appointed to bear fruit, the fruits of the Holy Spirit. And therefore, we are here for a purpose. And the purpose is to bear fruits of the Holy Spirit. And what are the fruits of the Holy Spirit? St. Paul speaks in detail. What are the fruits of the Holy Spirit? Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23. The fruit of the Holy Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. We have learned it in catechism. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. The fruits of the Holy Spirit. Now, they're called fruits. Why fruits? Fruits because these are the manifestations of the presence and power of the Holy Spirit. When there are apples on a tree, we would call that tree an apple tree. An apple tree will produce apples. Apples are the manifestations of an apple tree. Same way, when the disciples of Jesus are anointed with the Holy Spirit, these powers will be manifested in their lives. And they are powers of the Holy Spirit that will be born in them. And they're spontaneously and naturally born in them. They are fruits of the Holy Spirit. And that means the moment I commit my life to Jesus, these fruits will be born in me. And I should know this. They are fruits of the Holy Spirit. And for this, I must be united with Jesus. And that's why Jesus said, I'm the vine. You are the branches. You abide in me. I will abide in you. You be one with me. I will be one with you. When I abide in you and you abide in me, then the Holy Spirit will flow into you. The Holy Spirit is a life sap. And when the Holy Spirit flows into you, the Holy Spirit will be manifested in you by the fruits, by the powers of love and joy and peace and gentleness and kindness and self-control. The natural or supernatural manifestation of the powers of the Holy Spirit. And therefore, I must be united with Jesus. I must be surrendered to Jesus. Every moment of my life must be surrendered to Him. These fruits will be born in me. I should know this. The love in my heart, which is manifested on my face as a smile, should not be a hypocrisy. No, no. I should not be feigning love. That will be hypocrisy. That love, that smile on my face when I see someone must be coming spontaneously from my heart. A manifestation of the love in my heart, the gentleness, the kindness. It all must be the joy. It all must be a very natural or supernatural flowing out of the Holy Spirit from my heart. I remember I was asked to go to a parish to replace the parish priest for the evening mass. I was very tired. I went to the dining hall. I was given a cup of tea. There were two apples on the dining table. Since I was very tired, I took an apple and I bit that apple. It was wax. Looked colorful, attractive, but it was only an exhibit. I was irritated. Of course, I should have been more careful. You know, my dear friends, there are a lot of pieces of exhibition today. A priest, a teacher, a doctor, a parent. Pieces of exhibition. I may have a Roman collar. I may be a parent. I may be a doctor. If I'm not anointed with the Holy Spirit, I will irritate people. The smile on my face will not be a spontaneous manifestation of the love in my heart. The joy I show will not be the fruit of the Holy Spirit. It will be only a feigning of what I'm not. I'm not happy to meet you, but I just show it. And soon everybody would come to know about it. A lot of people are very unhappy and irritated at hypocrisy today. Well, am I scandalizing you? Perhaps we are already scandal-proof. What's important is to bear fruits of the Holy Spirit. And this is the urgent need of the time, to be united with Jesus, surrendering my life to Him, that we may have the fruits of the Holy Spirit to give to others. Real fruits. But then, there's a difference between a profession and a mission. Say, for example, an accountant or a sales girl is a profession. They are paid for that. An accountant is paid to write accounts, 8 hours work. A sales girl is paid to smile. It is a profession, it's a job. I'm a priest, a husband, a wife, a doctor, a teacher. It's a mission. There's a world of difference between a profession and a mission. A mission is not a job, but is given by the Lord, a continuation of the ministry of Jesus, called, appointed by the Lord. And therefore, we must be bearing fruit. Let me read for you the gospel of Mark. Mark chapter 11, verses 12 to 14 and 20. The next day, as they were leaving Bethany, he was hungry. Jesus was hungry. Seeing from a distance a fig tree in leaf, he went over to see if he could find anything on it. When he reached it, he found nothing but leaves. It is not the season for figs. And he said to it in reply, "May no one ever eat of your fruit again." And his disciples heard it. Early in the morning, as they were walking along, they saw the fig tree withered to its roots. Peter remembered and said to him, "Rabbi, look, the fig tree that you cursed has withered." My dear sisters and brothers, Jesus looking for fruits. It is not the season for fruits. And Jesus cursed that fig tree. That fig tree withered away. One might wonder, why? Why did Jesus curse that fig tree? Of course, in the scriptural language, this is an action prophecy. And that means this is a warning. Jesus was hungry. And today, Jesus is hungry. Jesus is hungry. And when Jesus is hungry, the fig tree must bear fruit. And who is this Jesus hungry? My dear sisters and brothers, I'm a priest, chosen, called, appointed to bear fruit for my people. For my people, when my people are hungry, I must be giving them fruit of love, of joy, of peace, of gentleness, of kindness. When someone comes to me sad, when someone comes to me in distress, I cannot say, "I'm busy. I'm a priest. I'm a priest chosen. I'm a priest appointed to bear fruit." Jesus is hungry, hungry for love, hungry to be understood. I'm a priest. I cannot be too busy for a hungry Jesus. I will have the curse. I will wither away. I will wither away. If priesthood is withering away today, it's because hungry Jesus is meeting with rejection. My dear sisters and brothers, your son shouting at you. You're the parent. You cannot shout back. You're the parent. You cannot shout back and say, "I'm the parent. How can you shout at me?" That is Jesus, hungry to be understood. Your son has a problem. And that's the way he's expressing how dissatisfied he is with the whole world. He's not getting a job.
He's got a degree. He's knocking door after door. He's not getting a job. He's wondering why. All his friends and classmates got a job. He's wondering, will he get a job ever? Where is he going to ask? How can he shout at a stranger? He can shout only at his father. You are the dad. Jesus, hungry, reaching out, looking for a fruit of love and gentleness. You cannot shout back. You must have time. You must have time for your son. You must be able to listen to him. You must be able to listen to him, understand him, and give him the fruit of understanding, of caring. If you shout back at him, you have lost him. The curse of Jesus, of his son, will be there. Your family will wither away. If your son leaves your house, well, who will be responsible? Your daughter sitting in the corner, depressed. You cannot say, why? Why are you sitting there, depressed? Come and help in the kitchen. Well, perhaps she should, and yet she went for an interview yesterday. She could not answer all the questions. She's sad. She's depressed. She does not know whom to say this. And she's just sitting in the corner. As a mother, you must go and sit with her and talk to her. Listen to her. Maybe she will not talk to you for half an hour. Sit with her, holding her hand for half an hour, and give her your time. She would want to lean on to your shoulder and cry. You have gained your daughter. You gained Jesus, who is hungry. Matthew chapter 25, verse 35. Jesus said, I was hungry and you fed me. Now, this is the last judgment. Jesus telling those on the right, I was hungry and you fed me. And the righteous people will ask, Master, when was it we found you hungry and we fed you? And the king will answer, the least of my brethren, when you fed them, it was me that you fed. Matthew 25:40. Whenever you did it to the least of my brethren, you did it to me. Whenever you did it to the least of my brethren, you did it to me. Jesus is identified with everyone sad, with everyone hungry, with everyone sick, with everyone abandoned. Everyone lower than you, everyone in need. Jesus is identified. And you must be able, my dear sisters and brothers, you and I, we must be able to see the face of Jesus in every one of them. Otherwise, the curse, the withering away, their experience will be there in me, in my church, in the world around. You know, my dear sisters and brothers, there's a danger that St. Paul is speaking about in Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 21.
when we, the disciples of Jesus, when we do not wait upon God for the anointing of the Holy Spirit, that we may be filled with the fruits of the Holy Spirit, there's a danger. We will be filled with the works of the flesh. And which are the works of the flesh? Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 21. Now, the works of the flesh are obvious: immorality, impurity, licentiousness, idolatry, sorcery, hatreds, rivalry, jealousy, outbursts of fury, acts of selfishness, dissensions, fractions, occasions of envy, drinking, bouts, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. If we are not anointed with the Holy Spirit, all these negativities will enter into our hearts. There's something beautiful. When the Holy Spirit descended upon the early church, the first thing that happened to us, the fruit of the Holy Spirit was manifested in such a fabulous manner. Let me read that for you from the book of Acts, chapter 4, verses 32 and 35. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The fruit of the Holy Spirit. You know, often we speak of the fruits of the Holy Spirit in the plural, but in the Bible, it's always the fruit of the Holy Spirit in the singular. And what is the fruit of the Holy Spirit? The fruit of the Holy Spirit is love. Love. And in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, St. Paul explains, illustrates from that one fruit, all the other fruits follow. St. Paul explaining all the other fruits are the manifestations of the one fruit, the love is. That one fruit was fabulously manifested in the early church. There was no one in need. My dear sisters and brothers, if in our community, in our family, wherever we are, if there is anyone in need, it is sure there's no Holy Spirit in us. If there's anyone in need of food, in need of love, in need of joy, there's no Holy Spirit in me. I must go out of my way. I must come out of my selfishness. I must go in search, spending myself on others. So much of love I must be filled with. I must forget myself in order to spend myself on others. And that's what the Holy Spirit will enable me to do. And that is surrender. Surrender. I surrender myself to Jesus that the Holy Spirit may fill my heart. I must know this. That's what I'm called for. I'm called for, I'm chosen for, I'm appointed for, to bear fruits, the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, come and fill me. My life. My life shall be destined by the purpose you have for me to live according to your fruits. I need to surrender my life to Jesus, and then you will fill me with your fruits. Spirit of God, every morning I will come to you waiting for your spirit, for your fruits to fill my heart, that I may live in the fullness of joy, love, and peace, and patience, and kindness, and gentleness, and self-control. Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, renew the face of the earth. Come, Holy Spirit, cast your fire, give us new birth. Come with your power, come with your grace. Come, Holy Spirit.